Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be telling you about another case that is going to be featured on ID's 9 at 9 lineup. If you missed my last video about the disappearance of Kyron Horman, I will be linking it down below in the description. Today, I bring you the story of a serial killer who terrorized the Wichita, Kansas area for nearly 20 years, the disturbing BTK. In the ID special, they actually interview BTK's daughter and find out what it was like growing up with him as a father and then later as an adult, finding out he was a serial killer. It airs May 30th at 9 p.m. Eastern time, so make sure to join me for that. BTK is one of the very first serial killer cases that really drew me in. My interest in true crime started at a very young age, and I vividly remember reading all about BTK's horrific crimes long before his inevitable capture. And I'll never forget the rush I felt when I was checking out at the grocery store, and there on the newsstand, on the cover of People magazine, was the face of BTK staring straight back at me. This man, who had eluded capture from law enforcement for 19 years, was finally in custody and unable to hurt anyone else. This nightmare began on January 15th, 1974, when four members of the Otero family were found slaughtered in their home. Joseph Otero, age 38, his wife Julie, 33, and two of their children, Josephine, 11, and Joseph Jr., 9, were discovered dead by the family's eldest child, Charlie, when he returned home from school. Later that spring, on April 4th, 1974, a woman named Catherine Bright, age 21, was found stabbed to death in her home. Both cases remained unsolved. And then, in October of that year, the Wichita Eagle newspaper received a letter from someone claiming responsibility for both crimes. The letter also stated, "The monster goes on." Residents of Wichita lived in constant fear and anticipation of this crazed murderer's next strike. Luckily for them, the killer remained at bay for a few years, but he was not done. He takes his next victim, Shirley Vianne, age 24, on March 17, 1977. She is found tied up and strangled in her home. Then again on December 8, 1977, Nancy Fox, 25, is also found tied up and strangled in her home. This time, the killer calls 911 to report the murder, as if to taunt the police. This is the first time they hear his voice. In February 1978, a local TV station in Wichita receives a letter from the killer. In this letter, he claims responsibility for the deaths of the Oteros, Catherine, Shirley, Nancy, and an unnamed victim. He also suggests different nicknames for himself, including the infamous BTK, standing for Bind, Torture, Kill. Now, if his taunting letters weren't bad enough, in April 1979, BTK waits inside the home of 63-year-old Anna Williams, a woman he has become obsessed with. But he leaves before she returns home. To make his presence known, he later sends Anna a letter informing her of his little visit. There is a 6-year period of silence. And then, on May 5th, 1985, the body of 53-year-old Maureen Hedge is found in a ditch. It's later discovered that she was actually murdered on April 27th. On September 16, 1986, 28-year-old Vicki Wegerle is found strangled in her home. He killed his last victim, Dolores Davis, on February 1st, 1991. Up until 2004, all these murders were one huge cold case. That year, BTK began sending packages and letters to newspapers and TV stations containing word puzzles and hiding packages around the city containing graphic descriptions of the Otero murders. The package that led to his eventual capture contained a floppy disk. After analyzing the purple floppy disk, police found the words Christ, Lutheran Church, and Dennis in the disk's metadata. This led them to Dennis Rader, a man who had been living under the disguise of church-going family man and Boy Scout leader his entire life. In 2005, Rader pled guilty to 10 counts of murder and is currently serving 10 consecutive life sentences. To dig into this case more and hear from BTK's own daughter, tune in to My Father, BTK, on Saturday, May 30th at 9 p.m. Eastern Time on ID. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye.